Hey everyone, welcome back to The Upgrade, where we discuss upgrading your home, your finances, but ultimately your life. Today's video, we're going to be talking about what you should do with your tax money. We've gotten all these stimulus. I wasn't able to make videos on time on what to do with your stimulus, but I am going to tell you what you should be doing with that tax refund, okay? Now before we get started, make sure that you subscribe to my channel. Also give this video a thumbs up if it helps you out, and let's get into the video. Okay, the number one thing you should do is to put some in your emergency savings. This could depend on your financial situation. However, I say a minimum of $500. Now, this could range from $500. If you have children, I would say up to $1,000. This is going to be the savings that you should never have to touch. This is going to be the savings that if something comes up that is very, very necessary, not, oh, my friends are going to Bali and I want to go. No, that's not an emergency. Necessary. Car issues, home issues, things like that. That's when you're going to dip into that fund. Other than that, you're not going to touch it. But I say, like I said, $500 to $1,000. So let's move to the next one. Put some in your children's savings. Now, this could be used for field trips, for birthday parties, if you do throw birthday parties. I personally don't. I actually have a video on how to be frugal with kids in a previous video, so I'll make sure to tag that down below. But just anything that you know might be coming up this year, it could be like your kids' sinking fund. And a sinking fund is basically something that you save purposely to eventually like sink it, take all the money out. So you can do it for that, or you can also just go ahead and start their college savings. And please do not touch it. Don't let it be a checking account that you have access to. Let it be an account that you open up, which is like usually a Safari savings club at most institutions. But check the interest rate and make sure that you get something that has a good interest rate. Of course, I am not a financial advisor. Please keep that in mind. Anything I give you is just for entertainment, but I cannot legally give you financial advice. So my favorite ones are like the Safari Savings Club. If you call your institution, hopefully it's a credit union, hopefully. But if you call your institution, you can ask them what type of accounts they have for children under 18 or under 16. And they'll usually tell you which ones they offer. And they usually accrue very, very great interest. I mean, better interest than we get as adults, right? So make sure you check that out. Well, let's say what not to do. Please do not buy a new car. Please do not. I gotta take a drink on that. Because I feel like y'all gonna buy a new car. No. You need to get a car that can get you from point A to point B. Or get a car that you can finance but with low payments. You do not need a 2021. You do not need a 2022. You don't need anything in the last, I would say, 5 years. If you can't afford it, please. Let me tell you something about these car salesmen. And I have friends that are car salesmen. So no shade to them. But here's the thing, to all my people who have bad credit, I wanna tell you this. They are trying to rip you off. They know that we can't afford those cars, but they tell us, oh, you can afford this. How can I afford it if I don't have the money to buy the thing in cash, right? So get out of that mindset feeling like you can afford it because you can afford the payments, but you can't afford that car. If you can't buy it straight off the lot, you can't afford it, right? And I'm telling y'all this from experience. My credit score was shot when I bought my car. It was like a 5-something. And I got a brand new 2016, because it was a 2016. It was actually 2015 when I bought the car. I got a brand new car for what? I was only making $11 an hour. Don't do it. No new car. I can't stress it enough. No new car. Next is to pay off that credit card or that loan. So pay off the loan or credit card so that you'll be able to snowball it into other debt and pay off your other debt. Or you can just put the payments into your savings account. Either one is good. There's no bad one. But I would say pay off your debt so you can slowly start seeing some money. Next is pay up rent for a month. Now, here's the thing. Your house mortgage or your rent is going to be like most likely your highest expense. If you don't have rent, that's great. You could just skip past this one. But if you do, then you should pay it up for a month and continue to pay it up until about Christmas time. So when I used to rent, I used to pay the rent twice in February because that's usually when I got my refund. And then I would keep paying regular all the way up until December, and then I wouldn't pay for December because it was always a month ahead. Now, some places don't allow you to pay upfront because the last place that I had didn't, but the place before that they did. And I would do it every time so that by Christmas time, I don't have a rent payment. So I don't have to worry about that. I could buy my gifts and not even stress about that. But I would say try that, and then that way you can get a break. Or even if you want to do it before your birthday, like you want to skip the month of your birthday because you got a trip planned and you don't want to have to pay rent. But that rent got to get paid. You get what I'm saying? So don't let it sit in your account. Pay it. So it's already gone. This is not the time to buy a house. Let me say why. Because they're going to try to get you. They're going to tell you like, oh yeah, house rates are all time low, blah, 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 blah. If I could have afforded an apartment and I got approved for 3x the rent, I don't make a lot of money. But if I could have gotten approved for 3x the rent somewhere, I would have never bought a house. Because some people say that's throwing away money. I disagree now that I'm actually a homeowner, but we'll get into that another time. Don't buy a house until you have a good lump sum saved up. Not just during tax time when you get this big lump sum at once. You get what I'm saying? Really sit down and think about it. Next is to pay up a monthly bill. Now here's the main one I love to pay off every time I get my tax money, because my insurance renews every February. I pay up my car insurance for 6 months. I don't want to think about it. I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to look at it. That's just one bill that I don't have anymore. That's something that I do every single time, every single year. And the reason why I love doing this is because it lets me see more money and I'm able to save more money. Pay up something, whether it be a phone bill or pay up your car note for a while. Do something that's gonna like relieve you. I don't recommend car note though, because if something happens to that car and you have gap insurance, it's gonna cover it. I don't really like paying up my car note. The only time I paid up my car note aggressively when I was almost paying it off. But other than that, I don't recommend paying up your car note. Pay up something else. And also to make sure that you only do this step if you already have your emergency savings funded. Okay, the next thing I recommend for parents, please go ahead and buy your kids the Christmas gifts now, or put it in a separate savings that's hard to access so that you won't spend it all. A lot of us are not financially literate because our parents were not financially literate and their parents were not financially literate. Literally, the only thing that helped me was like the people I have interacted with throughout my life. But I didn't know any better either. Well, what I'm saying is this. Buying all those clothes and that whole treat yourself mentality, if your kid is gonna have to go without, you can't do it. If your kids are older and y'all celebrate Christmas, you do wanna come through for Christmas. I need y'all to like really watch how y'all spend throughout the year. Write it down. Trust me. Okay? Because this is why I'm kind of getting off subject, but this is why I started my channel. I wanted to talk to people who just did not know. You know, a lot of us want better, but we don't know the first step. We don't know what we need to change. So that's what this channel is for. So I hope y'all don't take that offensively, but all those getting your hair done, getting your nails done all throughout the year. If you don't make the sacrifices now, you're going to eventually have to make them. And it shouldn't be during Christmas time when your kids are looking for that the most. And then my last thing is to just hold on to it and save it. I know I've mentioned saving a couple of times, but what I recommend doing is just putting, if you can, put all the money up into your savings. And just don't touch it throughout the year. Because the thing is, sometimes we'll pay up bills and something will come up. And then it's like, man, I wish I didn't pay up my so-and-so this many times. You know, I wish I would have saved some of that money. So it's okay to keep some of it. Like, hold on to a lot of it if you can throughout the year until next tax time. And then whatever you don't need, you can spend. Or you can put it towards something, whatever. But don't be so aggressive with paying off debt or paying up bills to where you're broke throughout the year. Know yourself. All right, so I hope y'all enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Also, make sure that you follow me on Instagram @theupgrade_Kiki, and I will see you all on the next video.